Saddle your worries to a cowboy's song and yodel your troubles away. Brand all your sorrows as you go rolling by with a yippee-ki-yo-ki-yay. Just a rope around the sun as he rolls by, so you can keep him shining way up there in the sky. Saddle your worries to a cowboy's song and yodel your troubles away. Odele, oh, odele, 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 odele. When I was a kid, old Stu Davis used to stop right there and say on the radio, well, good day, folks, thanks for listening, we'll see you next week. And I kind of said, come on, Stu, finish that song. So I had to grow up and do it. Here we are. I sings his cattle call. He's brown as a berry from riding the prairie, and he sings with an old western drawl. Born and raised in the Peace River Country, Northern Alberta, Canada. Born in Beaver Lodge. Two of his kids out of six were born in a hospital. And it was a log building. It's still standing. It's now a two-car garage. Cold country, but fun country. Oh, the place where we lived wasn't very big, some would call it a shack. We had to carry water and we shared with one another everything we had. We had to take a bath in the old wash tub on Saturday night. And we didn't have things like today, but we got along all right. We had to hang the milk in the well to keep it cool till supper time. Then after evening prayer, everybody was so tired they were in bed by nine. Then at early a.m. we were at it again to work another day. Oh, it used to seem hard, but I thank the good Lord I was raised that way. And I've got treasure dreams and memories of yesterday, when life was not as complicated as today. Oh, I thank the good Lord above for a home that was filled with love, and that my mama and papa gave me a chance to be raised that way. We used to do our chores and had to walk for miles to a country school. And that was in the days when they were not afraid to teach the golden rule. When folks are really neighbors, doing one another favors anytime they need. And everybody cared of what other people thought about the way we lived. How I'd like to go back, but I know I never can, 'cause the world has changed. No matter how I try, I have to realize I can't be the same. But there's something inside that will never, never die. It will always be from a heart full of love. I thank God above I was raised that way. And I've got treasured dreams and memories of yesterday, when life was not as complicated as today. Oh, I thank the good Lord above for a home that was filled with love, that my mama and papa gave me a chance to be raised that way. I thank my mama and papa, they gave me a chance to be raised that way. When I was still pretty young, my folks moved off the homestead and into the little town of Hythe. My dad had a blacksmith shop there. And I can remember 1942, the highway went right past the front of my dad's shop, and we were 40 miles south of Dawson Creek. I remember the convoys, the troop trains going up, and the warplanes going over when they built the Alaska Highway in 1942. But I'd just like to point out that it's not that I'm so old, it's just that I was born so long ago. Then my folks moved to the big city of Edmonton when I was about 15. I hated that place. Big cities, no hunting, no fishing, hadn't discovered girls. But my folks were born in Cullom, North Dakota. So I was an American citizen born in Canada. It didn't take too long and I was that prodigal son. When I left home, the sun was shining, headed south for the border and some fun. 21 years later, I'm returning, going home to bury my mom. Dear old mama cried as I was leaving, promised every day she'd pray for me. I know it broke her heart to see me leaving, only 16, wild as could be. Here I am now standing by her coffin. I see the woman who may give life to me. Too late now to tell her that I love her, or be the son she wanted me to be. Here we are now driving to the graveyard. Good thing I'm not driving, I can't see. Longing for the answer to a question. Now that mother's gone, who'll pray for me? Here I am now reading from her Bible. Scriptures that she underlined, I see. knowing from the tear-stained worn-out pages, heaven sent the love she had for me. Here I am now headed for the border. Heavenly Father, take a message, would you please? Someday I'll make that journey, I'll be with her, 'cause I've made the reservation on my knees. Yes, I've made the reservation on my knees.
You guys know the difference between a musician and a large pizza? A large pizza can feed a family of four. See, that was one of the big songs. And it was very big in Canada in 1975. Sat around, Hollywood wouldn't release it, said it's a good Mother's Day song. And then about 3-4 years ago, all of a sudden it took off in Spain and over there and played quite a few thousand times. See, I got 3 cents every time it played on the radio. Then they take 10%, they send it to BMI Nashville, they take 10%. I got $167. Where did that time go? All of a sudden, here we are. And with songwriting, there's a story behind every song. And old Dewey Wickman, the real cowboy type, the real thing. Him and I went to play music for an old friend we were losing, terminal cancer. Oh, Sam Webb. And we sang him a bunch of songs. And as we were leaving, Dewey had stomach cancer, didn't know it. And he had to stop and rest on the fence on the way out. And he looked at me and said, well, Rod, he said, I'm next. The good Lord's tugging on my lead rope. I said, Dewey, write that song. But Dewey didn't write. I was driving up by Chewila and I looked over at this old ranch, and all that was left of the house was a foundation. The barn was caved all in, and the fence was every direction. Lion pops him head, a lot of fence has fallen down. There comes the song. Oh, the good Lord's tugging on the lead rope, and I'll soon be heading home. A cowboy's life is bittersweet, hard but still it's fun. A lot of fence has fallen down along the trails that I've come. A lot of good times come and gone, but there's one truth I've found. The toughest trail there ever was leads to higher ground. And the good Lord's a-tugging on my lead rope. I don't have much time to do the things I'm supposed to do. I'm so far behind. Perhaps if I had a little slack, I'd get a few things done. But the good Lord's tugging on my lead rope, and I'll soon be heading home. Life's been good the way it was, I feel like I've been blessed. Now I'm looking forward to a time when I can rest. And when my chores have all been done, Lord, if I've earned a thing, a guitar's all I'll need up there and a place where I can sing. Oh, the good Lord's a-tugging on my lead rope, and I don't have much time to do the things I'm supposed to do. I'm so far behind. Perhaps if I got a little slack, I'd get a few things done. But the good Lord's tugging on my lead rope, and I'll soon be heading home. Oh, yeah, back in the old days, once upon a time, you know, when I was a young and I set out to be the best yodeler in Canada. I didn't know about the rest of the world. And we worked at it. One day we got something done. Thanks a lot to Dr. Jean Wardian from Gonzaga University. She was an opera teacher, took me as a student. 2 hours a week, an hour each time, she worked on me. And a year later she said, okay, now you're ready to record this song. Oh, I went across to Switzerland where all the yodels beat. A kidler de yodel with a yodeler. Climbed a big high mountain on a clear and sunny day. I fell in love with a yodeling gal and could not get away. Oh, she taught me to yodel. I don't know, dee-dee, oh, no, dee-dee, I don't know, dee-dee. She taught me to yodel. I don't know, dee-dee, I don't know, dee-dee. But being a Swede, see, I learned that in slow motion. See, my mother hid it from us for years that we were Swedish. But the kids at school figured it out. And I think it was a pickled herring sandwich and cold lutefisk in my lunch pail that gave me away. But so I learned it in slow motion. But that made it simple enough a Swede could learn it. All you had to do was turn it back on regular speed. Now I'm gonna teach you how to yodel just like me. It's easy while you're singing to go yodel-oody. First you take a deep breath and then exhale, one, two, three. Then you'll hear the yodeling if you listen close to me. And this is how to yodel. I don't know, dee-dee, oh, the low, dee-dee, I don't know, dee-dee. This is how to yodel. I don't know, dee-dee, I don't know, dee-dee, I don't know, dee-dee, I don't know, dee-dee, I don't know, dee-dee. Everybody help me out here. One more time. How do you live? And you know, it really happened. One day, it came over Paul Harvey. The rest of the story. And it was in the National Trade Music magazines. And sure enough, Rod Erickson was the best yodeler in Spirit Lake, Idaho. They told me when I was a kid, don't never yodel, son, it'll ruin your voice. And sure enough, it did. I'll show you how bad it can get. Streets of Laredo, as I walked out in Laredo one day, I spied a young cowboy wrapped up in white linen, wrapped up in white linen, as cold as the clay. Oh, beat the drum, slowly play the fife, slowly play the dead march. As you carry me along, take me to the green valley. There lay the sod o'er me, for I'm a young cowboy and I know I've done wrong. I see by your outfit that you are a cowboy. These words he did say as I boldly step high. Come sit down beside me and hear my sad story. I was shot in the breast and I know I must die. Lady, oh, Lady, go fetch me a cup of cool water to cool my parched lips
the poor cowboy said, before I returned, the spirit had left him, and he'd gone to his maker. The cowboy was dead.
So we beat the drum, slowly played the fife, lowly, bitterly wept as we bore him along. For we all loved our comrade, so brave, young, and handsome. We all loved our comrade, although he done wrong.
Well, let's see. Let's do something just kind of fun and easy. Well, I'm lonesome but happy, rich but I'm broke, and the good Lord knows the reason. I'm just a cowpoke. From Cheyenne to Douglas, all the ranges I know, for I drift with the wind, no one cares where I go. Well, I ain't got a dime in these old worn-out jeans, so I'll quit eating steak and go back to beans. But I'll pick up a 10-spot in Prescott, I know, by riding the Bronx in the big rodeo. Now, if I was a real cowboy, I'd be down here. Well, some evening in springtime, a filly I'll find, and I might spell no summer with her on my mind. But I'll never be branded, never be broke, for I'm just a range riding, drifting cowpoke. The old cowboy spent his whole life on the open range till he finally got so old and broken down and crippled up. He had to give up the cowboy way of life, moved to town. But as luck would have it, he ended up only a couple of blocks from the bar, so he could sneak down once in a while. One evening he was down there and had a couple, maybe an extra. Got up off his bar stool to leave and fell right flat in his face. Good grief, he thought, what went wrong there? So he crawled over to the window and pulled himself up, breathed some fresh air, headed for the door, fell flat in his face again. So he crawled on through the swinging doors and over to a lamppost, pulled himself up, breathed some more fresh air, and got all ready and steady and headed for home. Fell flat in his face again. Oh, to heck with it. It's only 2 blocks. He said, I'll crawl. So he did. Morning, his wife said, had a couple too many down there, didn't you? He said, what makes you think that? Bartender just called. You forgot your wheelchair. You never know where a song will come from or an idea. Worked the show with Jack Green up at Priest River one time. Stopped at the grocery store on the way home, and his gal was giving away kittens. And we could use a couple of Mausers around the fireside here, so I brought them home. My wife Nancy looks in the box, and what she saw was 2 half-starved kittens with little bodies and big heads. She said, of all the kittens in the world, these are the ugliest kittens I've ever seen. She named them Skinny and Scrawny. Well, This is a true story. Skinny and Scrawny were brothers. They were nearly identical twins. Scrawny was a loving, mouse-eating monster, and that was the biggest sin. But they were just cats, and that was that. Skinny asleep in the sun, a big red-tailed hawk up there. He spied dinner and down he came. Scrawny took him out of the air, used his brother for bait. They're a deadly pair. Skinny next time was the hitman, a Canada goose their prey. He grabbed the drumstick, Scrawny dove in. The goose thumped them both that day. The goose enjoyed it. Now the cats don't stray. Next time they cornered a pine squirrel, the squirrel held them both at bay. Scrawny climbed in, the squirrel climbed on and rode him for quite a ways. Everything they learned the hard way. One day Nancy felt tender-hearted, said it's been 20 below outside. I think I'll let them in and feed them in here, warm up their poor cold hides. They were just cats, but now they're house cats. Skinny ended up in a doll crib, Scrawny on a chair by the fire. And the look on their face said, from now on to be a house cat's our desire. If we gotta be cats, we wanna be house cats. There's a moral to this story, never be nice to a cat. They'll dig up your flower pots, puke on the rug, and terrible things like scat, cause they're just cats, even though they're house cats. They're just cats, and I love cats. Well, when we're doing songs, we want to do the world's saddest song also. There's 50 deaths in it, this blood and guts and fighting, and the hero dies in the end. About an old tomcat. Big Tom, Big Tom, Big Bad Tom. Well, every night from the alley when the moon was high, a big tough cat come a-strutting by. The claws in his paws were like 10-penny nails, and everybody knew he didn't step on the tail of Big Tom. After daylight, no one knew where he went, but everybody knew he didn't pay no rent. When you passed him on the street, you made a little bow, and if you spoke at all, you just said meow to Big Tom. Big Tom, Big Tom, Big Bad Tom. Now someone said he come from Tin Pan Alley, where he got into a fight over a cat named Sally. Cat fur flew, and after a little, why that stray cat's hide wouldn't string a fiddle, Big Tom. Then came that night on a one-way street, when they heard the rumble of four big feet. The iron bulldog grinning wide and left them all there paralyzed, side by side, except Tom. Well, when the rest of them stood there just frozen with fear, Big Tom grabbed a mouthful of bulldog gear. They found Tom's body after the clash under 49 cats in a barrel of trash, Big Tom. Big Tom, Big Tom, Big Bad Tom. Well, they dug through the beets and the coffee grounds and the watermelon rinds and the bozo clowns. When they reached the cabbage and the apple chorus, everybody knew they could do no more for Big Tom. Big Tom, Big Tom, Big Bad Tom. Now they never reopened that worthless can. They just left a note for the garbage man. When you pass by here, remove your hat, cause at the bottom of this can lies a big tough cat, Big Tom. Big Tom, Big Tom, Big Bad Tom. A tough top cat, Big Bad Tom. Thank you. That Swedish part kicks in every once in a while. You know, Ole and Sven were walking out through the countryside, and there in the middle of a wheat field was this Polish fella in a boat fishing. Ole said, Sven, we should tell him he won't catch any fish. Now Sven says we should, but he says we don't have a boat. That evening they run into this Polish fella in town, and he was carrying a sack. So Ole said, how many fish you catch? Polish fella said, if you can guess, he said, I'll give you both of them. The Ole said, five. Polish fella said, it's close enough, you only missed by one. Lena called Ole on the cell phone, as Ole says, Ole, you be careful out there on that freeway. I just saw on TV there's some nut driving the wrong direction. Ole said, oh no, he said, there's hundreds of them. Oh, well, we did a couple cat songs. Got to do a dog song. When I was a lad, and old Shep was a pup, over hills and meadows we played. I guess that was the only song there ever was, wasn't it? Just a boy and his dog, we were both full of fun. We grew up together that way. I remember the time at the old swimming hole when I would have drowned beyond doubt. But old Shep was there, to the rescue he came. He jumped in and helped pull me out. Now the years they rolled by and old Shep he grew old. His eyesight was fast growing dim. Then one day the doctor looked sad as he said, well, I can't do no more for him, Jim. With a hand that was trembling, I picked up my gun and I aimed it at Shep's faithful head. But I just couldn't do it, I wanted to run. How I wish they would shoot me instead. Now old Shep is gone, where the good doggies go, no more together we'll roam. But if dogs have a heaven, there's one thing I know, old Shep has a wonderful home. Now, just like they've done to country music and a lot of gospel, we modernized that song. We made it lively. See, it's better already. But this is modern, folks. Dead puppies, dead puppies, dead puppies, dead puppies. Dead puppies, they're no fun. They don't walk and they don't run. They don't ever bark and play. They just lay there and decay. Bow, 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 bow. Well, you're talking dead puppies, dead puppies, dead puppies, dead puppies. You can drag them to the park. They won't run and they won't bark. Won't roll over nor fetch a stick. They just lay there, it makes you sick. Bow, 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 bow. My wife says I got a twisted mind to come up with that one. My puppy died last fall. He was in school running down the hall. Now his traveling days are through. The lunch program got him in a stew. Bow, 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 bow. Well, you're talking dead puppies, dead puppies. I get very few requests for that song. I don't know why. When I was back in Minnesota, there was a little gal back there, the Heening family, Gracie Heening. And that little gal had got a hold of one of my CDs and learned to do some songs off of that. I put her on the bandstand with me. Here she is, 9 years old, and I hit the chord. She did all the yodeling in the song. I got to do the harmonies. But I hit the chord and she went. Yodeler, yodeler too. High on a mountain there once lived a boy. Down in the valley lived his only joy. Late in the evening at the dawn of the moon, their young hearts would thrill to this old mountain tune. I'll sing you our love song, you yodel to me. We'll meet and we'll kiss neath the evergreen tree. Oh, Molly, I love you. You are my love. We'll never be blue. yodel sweet Molly, and I'll sing our love song to you. His yodeling sweet Molly then went far away. His guitar was quiet from its drumming that day. Now high on the mountain the boy lives alone. The lonely green valley still echoes their song. I'll sing you our love song, you yodel to me. We'll meet and we'll kiss neath the evergreen tree. Oh Molly, I love you. You are my love, we'll never be blue. Yodel sweet Molly, and I'll sing our love song to you. Oh, I have a brother-in-law who's a cop up there in Edmonton. I go visit him once in a while. Got to go see Canada once in a while. And he's telling me last holiday season there, he's going to get himself a drunk driver. He's waiting for him. Sneaky bugger. So he parked way back from the bar a little, quite a ways. He's just watching it right there at closing time. He said about 5 minutes before closing time, this guy comes a staggering out, fell off the steps, hit both sides of the sidewalk, heading for the car, got to the parking lot, tried his key in a half a dozen different cars. Finally, a door opened. He fell across the seat, pulled himself up on the steering wheel. The headlights come on. He shut the headlights off. And he finally, he got it started, and he starts backing up. Stop. The windshield wipers come on, the squirters. Got them shut off. The headlights come on. He took off. He got him stopped about half a dozen blocks later. Give him the old breathalyzer test, and nothing showed up. Said, looks like I'll have to take you down to the station. My machine must be broke. No, the guy said, there's no alcohol on my breath. Well, he said, how could you be in the shape you're in and have no alcohol on your breath? He said, I am the designated decoy tonight. Designated decoy. I was up there in Canada helping my relative's farm, and I seeded 1,400 acres one spring. Did the cultivating and the seeding. And that old tractor engine after a while was singing me a tune. So all I had to do is put some words to that. There's no place short of heaven like Alberta in the fall. The wild rose blooms and prospers more beautiful each year. I'm weary of my travels, dreams that disappear. Now from down south of the border, I hear the Northland call. Alberta, you're my homeland, and I love you most of all. And when fall comes to Alberta, I'll be headed north again. I haven't seen Alberta since 4 months ago last spring. Listen to that sassy magpie, hear a prairie chicken call. There's no place short of heaven like Alberta in the fall. Where prairies touch the mountains kiss the sky. Land of dreams so rich it seems just made for you and I. For when God did cause creation, he gave it to mankind. But when he made Alberta, I know he had me in mind. And when fall comes to Alberta, I'll be headed north again. can't miss this one. Oh, in the blue Canadian Rockies, spring is sighing through the trees, and the golden poppies are blooming round the shores of Lake Louise. Oh, how my lonely heart is aching tonight for the home I'm longing to see. And oh, what I'd give if I could be there tonight with the sweetheart who's waiting for me. In the blue Canadian Rockies, spring is sighing through the trees, and the golden poppies are blooming round the shores of Lake Louise. Across the sea they call me, and I'm lonesome and so blue, for the blue Canadian Rockies and the girl I love so true. Lady on a roadie, on a roadie, lady on a roadie, on a roadie, lady on a roadie, on a roadie, on a roadie, in the bar in Toledo, across from the depot, on a bar stool she took off her ring. Thought I'd get closer, so I walked on over. I sat down and asked her her name. When the drinks finally hit her, she said, I'm no quitter, but I finally quit living on dreams. Well, I'm hungry for laughter, and I'm here ever after, whatever it is that the other life brings. In the mirror I saw him, and I closely watched him, thought how he looked out of place. He came to the woman who sat there beside me. He had a strange look on his face. His big hands were calloused, he looked like a mountain. For a minute I thought I was dead. But he started shaking, his big heart was breaking. He turned to the woman and said, you picked a fine time to leave me, Lucille, with four hungry children and a crop in the field. I've had some bad times and lived through some sad times, but this time your hurting won't heal. You picked a fine time to leave me, Lucille. Well, as with songs, they're written by stories, but sometimes the story changes. Now here it is, 20 years later, and just like on Paul Harvey, the rest of the story. In a bar in Las Vegas, across from the casino, on a bar stool with a big diamond ring. His big hands were calloused, he looked like a mountain, he had a big grin on his face. He said, I'm no quitter, now finally I've hit her. Thank goodness I'm a-living my dreams. Well, I'm hungry for laughter, and I'm here ever after, whatever it is that my millions will bring. I want to thank you for leaving, Lucille. The kids are all grown now, struck oil in the field. I've got me a young honey and a pocket full of money. Thank goodness your hurting has healed. I want to thank you for leaving, Lucille, you old floozy, you. Thank you for leaving, Lucille. You know, every once in a while that old Swedish part comes up. And you know, a lot of these stories are kind of true. See, when Lena and Ole was courting Lena, him and Sven were sharing an apartment, and Ole took off for a date with Lena one evening, and pretty soon he's back home again. Sven says, well, I thought you had a date with Lena, Ole. Well, he did. He said, well, how come you're home so soon? Well, he said, snuggled there on the sofa, and all of a sudden she turns off the TV, turns off the lights. I can take a hint, I went home. They did get married, though, but see, Ole never changed his ways. And he would stay out half the night or go fishing, stay away a night or two, and never tell her. Finally, Lena got tired of that. She said, Ole, how'd you like it if you didn't see me for 2-3 days? He said, that'd be fine. He didn't see her Friday or Saturday or Sunday. Monday evening, the swelling went down just enough he could barely peek out and see her. Ole and Sven went fishing, and Sven said, Ole, what's that thing you got there? Ole said, that's a thermos bottle. Oh, what does that do? Keeps things hot and keeps things cold. Oh, what you got in it? He said, a popsicle and 2 cups of coffee. And just a little EFSA will go a long way. Now EFSA's good for lots of things, and I can give you proof. For tiling on the kitchen floor or patching up the roof. Some folks even use it as the soles upon their feet. But if you are Norwegian, you think it's good to eat. And just a little EFSA will go a long way. Gives you indigestion most all of the day. So put it on your menu and you'll be sure to say that just a little EFSA will go a long way. Leif Erickson once had a boat, it was a leaky scow. He said to beat Columbus, we just got to leave right now. Well, the boat was leaking badly as they neared the USA. But they plugged a hole, y'all EFSA saved the day. And just a little EFSA will go a long way. Oofta. You know, there's two sayings, oofta and then there's ishta. Oofta, that's when you drop your gum in a chicken yard. Ishta, that's when you thought you found it. Ole goes to the lumberyard. Wants to buy some 2x4s. The clerk says, how long do you want them? He said, a long time, I'm building a house. The phone rings in the middle of the night. So Ole gets up and answers the phone. What? How in the world would I know? It's 500 miles from here. Lena said, who was that? Oh, some idiot wanted to know if the coast was clear. Well, I saw that fella when he come across the pond. His eyes are blue and his hair was blonde. He looked so bewildered it was easy to see. He looked like a pickled herring eater to me. He was a blue-eyed, blonde-haired, sweetest svenska poikin boy. Spekachut lafsa, sweetest svenska poikin boy. I love lutefisk, sweetest svenska poikin boy. He looks a lot like me. Well, he up from the ship and he crashed to the ground. And he started to hop and a flopping around. I asked him what's the matter, this is what he said. I got to hop around, I just broke my leg. Well, I asked Svenska Poika Boy, now what's your line? He said, playing polka music and a yodel fine. So that is the reason that I came to this land. I come to get a job in a Nordic fest band. He was a blue-eyed, blonde-haired, Swedish Svenska Poika Boy. Speaking to the left, so Swedish Svenska Poika Boy. I love lutefisk, Swedish Svenska Poika Boy. He looks a lot like me. Odelay, odelay. This is called a Delvaccio, made in Sao Paulo, Brazil. It's got an amplifier in it. Nancy saw Chet Atkins on TV one day, and he had his favorite guitar. It was one of these. And I had a sister who was in Brazil, missionary for, wasn't New Tribes, but one of those. So we wrote her a letter. He went to the factory and got it. Cost me $70 with the case. And that was a long time ago. Where are you going, my little one, little one? Where are you going, my baby, my own? Turn around and you're tiny, turn around and you're grown. house of your own. Turn around, turn around, turn around, you're a young wife with babes of your own. Yeah, it's kind of fun for different songs. When Irish eyes are smiling, sure tis like a morning spring. In the lilt of Irish laughter, you can hear the angels singing. And when Irish eyes are happy, all the world is bright and gay. And when Irish eyes are smiling, so they'll steal your heart away. My wild Irish rose, the dearest flower that grows, you may search everywhere, but none can compare to my wild Irish rose. My wild Irish rose, the dearest flower that grows. And someday for my sake, she may let me take a bloom from my wild Irish rose. Over in Killarney, many years ago, my mother sang a song to me in tones so soft and low. Just a simple little ditty in her quaint old Irish way. I'd give the world if I could hear her sing that song today. Tooraloo-ra-loo-ra, tooraloo-ra-la. Now don't you cry, oh, tooraloo-ra-loo-ra, tooraloo-ra-la, tooraloo-ra-loo-ra. 'Tis an Irish lullaby. Oh, I love the silver that shines in your hair, and the brow that's all wrinkled and furrowed with care. Oh, I love the dear fingers so toil-worn for me. Oh, God bless you and keep you, dear Mother McGree. Grandpa and Grandma Erickson come from Sweden in the late 1800s. Settled in around Cullum, North Dakota. Homesteaded. Had 10 kids. Then the Dust Bowl years come along. And a lot of people left North Dakota. Grandpa and Grandma Erickson picked up and moved up to northern Alberta. A couple of the kids were grown, and a lot of the kids were little. He was 65 years old then. Went north and built another successful farm. But you know, typically the men from the old country, they never give mother the credit that she deserves. Finally, in her old age, they're sitting there rocking one evening. Grandpa finally gets around to it. He says, "You know, Mother," he says, "I love you." She said, "What? I can't hear you." He said, "I love you. Can't hear you." He said, "I love you." She said, "So what? I'm tired of you too." Well, you know, fellas, if you write them a little poem or something, flowers don't work. I brought home flowers one Mother's Day, and my wife Nancy looked at me and said, "Uh-oh, what'd you do now?" Well, see, but if you write them something, you know, I got quite a bit of mileage out of this one, see. Thank you, darling, for being what I idolize. And I thank you for putting this light in my eyes. And I thank you for doing the things that you do. Darling, thank you for just being you. I thank you for the way that you hold me each night. And I thank you for the way you make everything turn out right. I thank you for the love that you've given so true. Darling, thank you for just being you. sometimes I do. I forget to say it, how you mean more to me than my life. And I could easily be the luckiest man alive, just having you as my wife. I thank you for the way that you hold me each night, and I thank you for the way you make everything turn out right. I thank you for the love that you've given so true, darling, thank you for just being you. Darling, thank you for just being you. Now, Nancy and I have been married for 50 years plus. Not my fault. But we had two boys, Christopher Keith and Jonathan Wade. Christopher, he's the one that tore apart all the TV sets to make see how they're made and understood what he's looking at. Ended up being a design engineer for communications, state of Alaska. Sharp kid. Jonathan Wade, he just liked music. He liked the piano. Well, he was a good songwriter, and we lost him in a car accident in 1984. Well, that's a tough time to go through, but one night I had a dream, and in that dream, all my questions were answered, and this is the story. One shoe off, one shoe on, twiddle diddle dumpling, my son John, Jonathan Wade. Mom, he said, when I grow up, I wonder what I'll be. Grandpa's a logger, dad's an electrician, that don't seem to fit me. I'd rather be a kid, play my piano, do the things I love to do. I love life the way it is right now, and Mom, I love you too. John's in heaven with Jesus now, knows for sure he's real. John don't have to worry now, he's got a better deal. Well, I dreamed about my boy the other night, holding hands with mother and I. And the love and the peace and the joy in his face had to come straight from on high. You know, I said, son, this don't seem right. Beyond the grave we're not supposed to see. He said, God allowed this. He's been just so good to me. And I asked if he's playing his piano and working with kids, and he said, oh yeah, but there's a lot more than that going on. There's just so many things to do up there that I should be getting on home. I told him how hard it was on Mother and I losing him. He said, I know. Sorry about that. But I'll be around. You see, it's only 20 minutes from home to here and back. John's in heaven with Jesus now, knows for sure he's real. John don't have to worry now, he's got a better deal. Jonathan Wade, Jonathan Wade. Way out on the mountain where the wildflowers bloom and the fragrance of roses are like sweet perfume, lives my little darling, my sweet little dove. She's the pride of the mountains, the girl that I love. Oh, the bluebirds are singing, dee-o-lo-dee-o-lay-dee. Church bells are ringing, dee-o-lo-dee-o-lay-dee. Soon we will marry, lady-o-lay-dee, and have an alpine home. Well, her eyes are like diamonds, her hair soft and fine. Cheeks are like roses, her lips are like wine. Voice soft and gentle like angels above. She's the girl that'll marry the girl that I love. Oh, the bluebirds are singing, dee-o-lo-dee-o-lay-dee. Church bells are ringing, dee-o-lo-dee-o-lay-dee. Soon we will marry, lay-o-lay-dee, and have an alpine honeymoon. When I was a youngster, my mother used to sing a song around the house in Swedish. And later on, it got discovered. George Beverly Shea went across the pond, discovered it, translated it, and brought it back. I was about 1948. But it went like this. Dobre starsha lennutelov songslu osturigu Dobre starsha lennutelov songslu osturigu Oh Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the worlds the hands have made, I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe displayed. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. When Christ shall come, with shout of acclamation, to take me home, what joy shall fill my heart. Then I shall bow in humble adoration and there proclaim, my God, how great thou art. Dobre starsha lennutelov songslu osturigud Dobre starsha lennutelov songslu osturigud The Norwegian was shipwrecked on a lonely island with a beautiful girl. That evening, as the sun went down, it started getting chilly, and she snuggled up to the Norwegian and said, if you could snuggle tonight, keep me warm. She said, I could make you awfully happy. He said, what? You've got Copenhagen? Out on the mountain, so happy and free. There lives a maiden, she's waiting for me. Out on the lake, we'll drift with the tide and hear those chime bells ring. Chime bells are ringing, dee-o-doo-doo-dee. I'm walking but singing, dee-o-doo-doo-dee-doo-dee. Sleep, my little lover, dee-o-doo-dee-doo-dee. Up on a summer's eve, dee-o-doo-lay-o-doo-lay-o-doo-lay-o-doo-dee. Moonbeams were shining as I kissed her there. Nightbirds were singing, perfume filled the air. Each little star just twinkled with glee while heaven smiled on me. Chime bells are ringing, dee-o-doo-dee. I'm walking but singing, dee-o-doo-dee-doo-dee. Sleep, my little lover, dee-o-doo-dee. Up on a summer's eve, now you guys have heard the saying, no job is too tough if you hold your mouth right. So it's all in the way you hold your mouth, and that's the secret to yodeling too. All you have to do is watch the lips and you know exactly how. Here we go, watch close. Did you get it? Everybody help me here, you know. Oh, lady, oh, lady, oh, lady, oh, lady, oh, because I'm getting old, I need help. Here we go. Get the breath when I do. Lady, oh, lady, lady. I forgot myself. The yodeler, one more time. The yodeler. Well, I used to be a railroad bum, living on the go. I rode freight from Canada down to Mexico, from sunny Cal to Minnesota, where the rippling waters fall. Never seemed to have a dime, but I had myself a ball, singing hi-dee, hi-low, he-la-la-la-dee-la-lo. Used to be a railroad bum, but I'm not anymore. Singing hi-lee, hi-lo, he-la-la-dee-la-lo. Used to be a railroad bum, but I'm not anymore. Well, I walked into the silver dollar in Reno one night. Put a quarter in the one-armed band, and in the lemons lined up right. Well, I took my winnings and I played some poker, and I won 10,000 more. Used to be a railroad bum, but I'm not anymore. Singing hi-lee, hi-lo, he-la-la-dee-la-lo. Used to be a railroad bum, but I'm not anymore. Singing hi-lee, hi-lo, he-la-la-dee-la-lo. Used to be a railroad bum, but I'm not anymore. When the cotton's white in Tennessee and the shrimp boats sail in Maine, each picking time soon will find me riding the Georgia train. Cause I get restless when I'm still, though I guess I always will. Gotta be a traveling, moving on over another hill. Singing hi-lee, hi-lo, he-la-la-dee-la-lo. Used to be a railroad bum, but I'm not anymore. Singing hi-lee, hi-lo, he-la-la-dee-la-lo. Used to be a railroad bum, but I'm not anymore. Yes, I used to be a railroad bum, but I'm not anymore. I stroll through an old mission garden, and as I was kneeling alone, an arm gently fell on my shoulder. 'Twas the Padre of old San Antonio. We went for a walk in the garden, and as we were talking alone, he told how he came to the mission in old San Antonio. Then the chapel bells they rang, and an angel chorus sang, me a more a timber rail from the sky. Then he kneeled down to pray in the garden, and he whispered me a more, me call a son. Then I knew that his love was an angel,
the Padre of old San Antone. Then the mission bells they rang, and an angel chorus sang, "Mi amor, tamboril from the sky." Then he kneeled down to pray in the garden, and he whispered, "Mi amor, mi corazón." Then I knew that his love was an angel, the Padre of old San Antone. The Padre of old San Antone.
Well, back about 1800 and some, Louisiana couple had a red-headed son. No name suited him, Jim, Jack, or Joe, so they just called him Billy Bayo. Billy, Billy Bayo, watch where you go, you're walking on quicksand, walk slow. Billy, Billy Bayo, watch what you say, a pretty girl will get you one of these days. Now Billy was a boy kind of big for his size, red hair, freckles, and big blue eyes. 13 years from the day he was born, Billy fought the battle of the Little Big Horn. Billy, Billy Bayo, watch where you go, you're walking on quicksand, walk slow. Billy, Billy Bayo, watch what you say, oh, a pretty girl will get you one of these days. Well, one fine day Billy cried, "Ho, ho, I can whip the feathers off of Geronimo." He smarted off, the chief got mad, that nearly ended our Louisiana lad. Billy, Billy Bayo, watch where you go, you're walking on quicksand, walk slow. Billy, Billy Bayo, watch what you say, a pretty girl will get you one of these days. Well, one day in 1878, a pretty girl walked through Bill's front gate. He didn't know whether to stand or run, he wound up married cause he didn't either one. Billy, Billy Bayo, watch where you go, you're walking on quicksand, walk slow. Billy, Billy Bayo, watch what you say, pretty girl will get you one of these days. Pretty girl will get you one of these days. I hear the sound of distant drums far away, far away. And if they call for me to come, then I must go and you must stay. So marry, marry me, let's not wait. Let's share all the time we can before it's too late. Love me now, for now is all the time there may be. Oh, if you love me, Mary, would you marry me? I hear the sound of bugles blow far away, far away. And if they call for me to go across the sea so wild and gray, so marry, marry me, let's not wait. For the distant drums could change our wedding day. Love me now, for now is all the time there may be. Oh, if you love me, Mary, would you marry me? Yes, if you love me, Mary, would you marry me?
Well, I remember when I was a lad,
times are tough and things are bad, but there's a silver lining behind every cloud. Just poor farmers, that's all we were, trying to make a living out of blackland dirt. We'd get together in a family circle singing loud.
Daddy sang bass,
Mama sang tenor,
me and little brother would join right in there. Singing seems to help the troubled soul. One of these days, and it won't be long, I'm gonna join him in a song.
We'll get together up yonder in a little while. No, the circle won't be broken by and by, Lord, by and by.
Daddy sang bass,
Mama sang tenor,
me and little brother would join right in there. In the sky, Lord, in the sky.
Well, I remember right after work, Mama would call in all of us. You could hear us singing for a country mile. Now little brother has done gone on, but we'll rejoin him in a song. We'll get together up yonder in a little while.
Daddy sang bass,
Mama sang tenor,
me and little brother would join right in there. Singing seems to help the troubled soul. One of these days, and it won't be long, I'm gonna join them in a song.
We'll get together up yonder in a little while. No, the circle won't be broken by and by, Lord, by and by.
Daddy sang bass,
Mama sang tenor,
me and little brother would join right in the sky, Lord, in the sky. In the sky, Lord, in the sky.
On a hill far away stood an old rugged cross, the emblem of suffering and shame. But I love that old cross, where the dearest and best for a world of lost sinners were slain.
So I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown.
The old rugged cross I will ever be true. Its shame and reproach gladly bear. Then he'll call me someday to my home far away, where his glory forever I'll share.
I'll cherish the old rugged cross till my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown. Exchange it someday for a crown.
Thank you. Now, Stuart Hamblin was was a hound hunter. He liked to hunt bobcats and cougars especially. Out in Arizona, they got run into a big blizzard. He told the guide, and he said, and the guide said to him, we gotta quit. Stewart said, I'm not going back without that missing hound. So they headed for a cabin close by. As they got there, the guide said, there's a dead man in that cabin. Stewart says, how do you know? Well, he said, that dog sitting on the porch would be inside in this blizzard with him. If he were alive or if he were gone, he'd be with him. He went in the cabin, and sure enough, the old feller was laying on a cot by the wall. Stewart had a box of crackers. He fed that starving hound some crackers and the rest of his hound. And by the light of the fireplace that night, he wrote this song and on the cracker box.
This old house, what do my children? This old house, what do my wife? This old house was home and comfort as we fought storms of life. This old house once rang but left. This old house heard many shout. Now she trembles in the darkness when the lightning walks about.
Ain't gonna need this house no longer. Ain't gonna need this house no more. Ain't got time to fix the shingles. Ain't got time to fix the floor. Ain't got time to all the hinges or to mend the window pane. Ain't gonna need this house no longer. I'm getting ready to meet the saints.
Now this old house is a-getting shaky. This old house is a-getting old. This old house lets in the rain. This old house lets in the cold. Oh, my knees are getting chilly, but I feel no fear or pain, 'cause I see an angel peeking through a broken window pane.
Ain't gonna need this house no longer. Ain't gonna need this house no more. Ain't got time to fix the shingles. Ain't got time to fix the floor. Ain't got time to all the hinges or to mend the window pane. Ain't gonna need this house no longer. I'm getting ready to meet the saints.
Now this old house is afraid of thunder. This old house is afraid of storm. This old house just groans and trembles when the light wind flings its arm. This old house is a needin' shingles. This old house is needin' paint. Just like me, it's tuckered out, but I'm getting ready to meet the saints.
Ain't gonna need this house no longer. Ain't gonna need this house no more. Ain't got time to fix the shingles. Ain't got time to fix the floor. Ain't got time to all the hinges or to mend the window pane. Ain't gonna need this house no longer. I'm getting ready to meet the saints.
And my old hound dog lies asleeping. He don't know I'm gonna leave. Else he'd break up by the fireplace and he'd sit there and howl and grieve. But my hunting day's over. Ain't gonna hunt the coon no more. Gable Run brought down my chair when the wind blew down the door.
Ain't gonna need this house no longer. Ain't gonna need this house no more. Ain't got time to fix the shingles. Ain't got time to fix the floor. Ain't got time to all the hinges or to mend the window pane. Ain't gonna need this house no longer. I'm getting ready to meet the saints.
Ready to meet the saints.
Oh, baby, my life gets so lonely when I dream about you. Can't live without you. That's why I dream about you. Baby, mine, if I could only put my arms around you, my life would be so fair. Oh, baby, tossing and turning in my slumber. Oh, baby, I keep holding you, it seems. Oh, baby, I'd give you kisses without number, but only in my dreams.
needs. That's why I say if I could only put my arms around you, my life would be so fair. Oh, baby, tossing and turning in my slumber.
Oh, baby, I keep holding you, it seems.
Oh, baby, I give you kisses without number, but only in my dreams. That's why I say if I could only put my arms around you, my life would be so fair. Oh, baby, my life would be so fair. Oh, baby, my life would be so fair. Would you believe this guy was a tenor singer in a gospel quartet in Alabama? We can prove it. Do you believe me?
Wish that I was on a rocky top down in the Tennessee hills. Ain't no smoggy smoke on a rocky top, ain't no telephone bills. Once I had a girl on a rocky top, half bear, the other half cat. Wild as mink, but sweet as sooty pop, I still think about that. Rocky Top, you'll always be, oh sweet home to me. Good old Rocky Top, Rocky Top, Tennessee. Rocky Top, Tennessee. Once two strangers climbed old Rocky Top, looking for a moonshine still. Strangers ain't come down from a Rocky Top, reckon they never will. Corn won't grow at all on a Rocky Top, dirt's too rocky by far. That's why all the folks on a Rocky Top get their corn from a jar. Rocky Top, you'll always be home sweet home to me. Good old Rocky Top, Rocky Top, Tennessee. Rocky Top, Tennessee. Well, I've had years of cooped up city life, living like a duck in a pen. All I know that it's a pity life can't be simple again. Rocky Top, you'll always be home sweet home to me. Good old Rocky Top, Rocky Top, Tennessee. Rocky Top, Tennessee. Rocky Top, Tennessee. Well, say hello, Mary Lou.
Goodbye, heart.
Goodbye, heart. Sweet Mary Lou, I'm so in love with you.
I'm in love with Mary Lou,
Mary Lou. That will never part. So hello, Mary Lou, goodbye, heart. I passed you by one sunny day, flashed those big brown eyes my way, knew I was in love forevermore. You know I don't fool around, keep both feet right on the ground. Never knew I needed you before.
I say hello, Mary Lou, goodbye, heart.
Goodbye, heart.
Sweet Mary Lou, I'm so in love with you. I'm in love with Mary Lou, Mary Lou. That will never part. So hello, Mary Lou, goodbye, heart.
I saw your lips, I heard your voice, I knew I didn't have a choice. Wild horses couldn't make me stay away. I dream about that moonlight night, arms around you oh so tight. All I had to do was up and say,
I say hello, Mary Lou, goodbye, heart.
Goodbye, heart. Sweet Mary Lou, I'm so in love with you.
I'm in love with Mary Lou, Mary Lou. That we'll never part.
So hello, Mary Lou, goodbye heart.
I say hello, Mary Lou,
goodbye heart.
Goodbye heart.
Sweet Mary Lou, I'm so in love with you. I'm in love with Mary Lou, Mary Lou, that we'll never part. So hello, Mary Lou, goodbye heart.
I say hello, Mary Lou, goodbye heart.
High up on the mountain, boys, what do you see? Bear tracks, looking back at me. Better get your rifles, boy, before it's too late. Old Slowfoot's got a little pig and he's heading for the gate. Well, he's
big around the middle and he's brought across the rub. Going 90 miles an hour, taking 30 foot a jump. Never been cornered and he's never been treed. Some folks say he looks a lot like me.
Winter's coming on and it's 20 below. River's frozen over, so where can he go? Chase him up the hollow, boy, we'll trap him in the well. Shoot him in the bottom just to hear him yell.
Well, he's big around the middle and he's brought across the rope. Going 90 miles an hour, taking 30 foot a jump. Never been collared and he's never been treed. Some folks say he looks a lot like me.
Got me some money and I bought me some bees. Started making honey way up in the trees. Cut down all the trees cause the honey's all gone. Old Slewfoot done moved in and made himself at home. Well, he's
bigger out in the middle and he's brought across the rock. Growing 90 miles an hour, taking 30 foot at a jump. Never been collared and he's never been treed. Some folks say he looks a lot like me.
Well, he's bigger out in the middle and he's
brought across the rock. Going 90 miles an hour, taking 30 foot at a jump. Never been collared and he's never been treed. Some folks say he looks a lot like me.
Elvira.
Yeah.
Elvira.
My heart's on fire for Elvira.
Well, giddy up,
boom, ba, boom, ba, ba, bow, bow.
Giddy up,
boom, ba, boom, ba, ba, bow, bow.
High or silver away. Well, eyes that look like heaven, lips like sherry wine. That little girl showed us know how to make my heart shine. Well, I get a funny feeling, oh, up and down the spine. Cause I know that my Elvira's mine.
Elvira.
Elvira.
Yeah.
Elvira.
My heart's on fire for Elvira.
Well, giddy up,
boom, ba, boom, ba, ba, bow, bow.
Giddy up,
boom, ba, boom, ba, ba, bow, bow.
High,
oh, silver away.
Well, tonight I'm gonna meet her at the Fireside Cafe. I'm gonna give her all the love I can, yes I am. Well, she's gonna jump and holler, cause I saved up a whole $2. We're gonna search and find that preacher man.
Elvira. Yeah.
Elvira.
My heart's on fire for Elvira.
Well, giddy up,
boom, ba, boom, ba, ba, bow, bow.
Giddy up,
boom, ba, boom, ba, ba, bow, bow.
High on silver away. Well, I'm singing Elvira.
Yeah.
Elvira.
My heart's on fire for Elvira.
will the giddy up.
Giddy up, boom, ba, boom, ba, ba, bow, bow.
Giddy up,
boom, ba, boom, ba, ba, bow, bow.
High, oh, silver away. Well, I said, high, oh, silver.
I'm thankful for the peace God gives me, thankful that He saved my soul, thankful for my wonderful family and all the friends I've come to know, thankful for my brothers and sisters and Jesus and the wonderful tie that binds. But the best part of living in this old world's gonna be when I say goodbye, when I say goodbye to this old world and I touch that heavenly shore. All the things I've had to go through down here, well, they won't be remembered no more. All the wonderful things that He promised to me will all of a sudden be mine. But the best part of living in this old world is gonna be when I say goodbye. I said the best part of living in this old world is gonna be when I say goodbye. Goodbye.